1, 2, 3.
I mean, would you wanna take? Like friends? Why are you saying that?
What are we doing next?
Why you disturb me? And you put jam with jam with jam.
Yeah.
I wanted to continue, didn't let me. Witam was kochani bardzo serdecznie. Namaste. Dzisiaj na waszą prośbę jestem ponownie z Warunem i będziemy robić kontynuację vloga z serii Co zaskoczyło mnie w Indiach. Tak jak już mówiłam wcześniej, wiele rzeczy mnie zaskakuje, będzie zaskakiwać w tym kraju i chcielibyśmy przybliżyć wam to, co mnie zaskoczyło przez ostatnie lata. So what surprised me, and always we coming to the point of vegetarian concept. Yes, few months ago, Warren told me I was admitted to the school where I was not allowed to have non-vegetarian meal. And I was like, hello, you are not allowed at home. You are not allowed at school. I mean, not you, I know you are vegetarian, but other kids, no, they are not allowed.
Some schools, I'll explain, some schools in India have the concept that the meal that you get from home or the meal that's going to be served in the school is going to be vegetarian. Because there are a lot of families that come from a vegetarian background and they do not want their kids at an early age to get an option of eating meat, because kids are small. They see their friend eating something, they'll go and eat. So they want their kids not to be exposed, and they're very careful about what they eat at home or what their kids are going to eat. So parents are concerned. So when you go to school, if you look at it, the school hours are such that at least one meal the child will always have in school. Either your school will provide it to you or you get it from home. So in my school, there were actually two breaks. One was a very small break at 10:30 in the morning in which you used to get food from home. In that food, the school had clearly instructed people who would eat meat that kindly do not give meat to your kids to bring to school. And secondly, the lunchtime was at 1:30, I guess, and the lunch was given by the school and it was 100% vegetarian. So the argument that I think that would have been agreed upon by everybody was that people who eat meat, the kids, once they go home, they will obviously have an option. But the vegetarian kids, they have to be, it's better not to expose them, because as I said, the children would copy another children, they would not know meat is something that I should not have according to their family or their backgrounds.
Considering parents' opinion about everything, about your friends, about your boyfriend, whoops, sorry, there is no boyfriend, girlfriend, but yeah, despite of this, we are boyfriend, girlfriend, but what I'm saying, who will be your future partner? What you gonna do, which university you gonna join, and which, what you wanna study?
Well, I would say that taking parental advice on every step, no, nobody does that. I don't think so, that's true. But yes, considering their advice, because we believe that they've seen more life, they've seen more problems, they've gone through a lot, they've matured more than us. I would definitely say that people watching this video would agree that you're not the same as you were 18 when you were 28 or when you're 35. Obviously you grow up, you mature, you know how to analyze a problem when it comes your way, how to stay calm and focus, and there are many things that you learn as you keep growing in your professional life, personal life. So when it comes to taking big decisions like what college you have to go to or what career you should choose, or who your partner should be, definitely parental advice and family advice, as a matter of fact, elders of the family in India is very much respected, because everybody considers that these are big decisions. If you go wrong, it can alter your life altogether. It can, imagine you end up in a profession doing something that you don't like. It's a very troubled situation to be in. Or you end up with a partner that you realize, oh, I did it because I was young and stupid and I didn't realize the complete facts. So it many things can go wrong, many things can go right also. But whenever a decision is made, just to weigh the pros and cons and also to get a different angle or perspective about things, definitely you go to your parents or close family members, because you believe, you trust them. You trust them, basically. You know that these people would never ever betray you or they would have any ulterior motive in giving you an advice towards something. So yes, it is considered a lot, but it's not like the final final straw that they've said it and you gotta do it. I've seen with my parents, with my friends and their parents, everybody's becoming more of a friend kind of friendly vibe. Like you can talk to your parents about much more things than I would say my father in his era, or his father, my grandfather in his era, would talk to his father. So I would say yes, taking parental advice or advice from somebody who's really close to you, who you trust, is one of the most important things.
What surprised me as well, and also is about the parents, what I appreciate and what I really like, that the affection towards the elders, it's really big. You're taking care of them. It's not so many old homes. You have, as you have big families, you're really taking care of the parents. You keep them at home. They are treated very, very nicely. And this is what I love about Indian culture.
I would say that in our culture, we are very sentimental. I think if that is how I would put it. We believe in taking care of each other at the worst times, at the best times, and not telling ourselves, oh, it's my life and I will do whatever I want. We do take care of our parents. Sometimes we stay together, like in my household, my grandfather, my grandmother, dad, mom, me, everybody used to stay together. My dadi, my grandmother is still with me. The thing is, in India, I think how this culture started was, in India, previously we used to have big homes. And many families used to stay together. Like my grandfather, my father's father, he was staying in a huge house in Jaipur. And that house was so big, there were 25 people staying there. But obviously you take care of your parents till the end. I would feel, and I'm sure many of the people watching this video from India and everybody would feel that letting go of their parents at the time when they need you the most is a heart-sinking sensation. It makes you question your own morals. It makes you question your own personality or what you've learnt in life or where you are heading in life. I would think that they've invested their entire life, time, money, happiness in me, and if I am not there at this point of time when they need the most, what good am I? Because if you look at it, India has been a poor country since last so many years. We've been ruled by everybody. And if you notice this, that when you don't have a lot, you have people around you. That's your support structure. That is where you derive your happiness from the emotion, from the love, from the fighting, from having people around you that you trust. So the families are made like that in India, that we all stay together and we don't have this old home concept. I was really shocked. About 6 years back, I met somebody, not from India, he was from
Sweden.
From Sweden. And he had four brothers and his mom was in the old home. So I asked him, I was like, why isn't she staying with you? Well, what he said is also logical. I mean, it made sense to me. Because he said, see, the cost of living is so high, me and my wife both have to work for us to afford. They had a child very late on because they had to pay off their loans to buy a house. Finally, they had a baby, they had to take care of the baby. It's expensive staying there, he said. And the kind of medical health my mother needs and the attention she needs 24 hours, we just cannot do it. Either we earn or either we stay at home. We can't afford it. But I kind of understood that aspect also, because if given an option, why would anybody lose their mother? Everybody loves their mother and father. I mean, that's across all ethnic groups. So that the guy that said gave me all this information, I was kind of agreeing also, but I was kind of feeling sorry also, that you know, why the situation has arisen, something like this.
When I was operating my flight as a crew, many flights to India, I realized that many passengers from around the world, they're traveling on the medical visa. And of course, many people have this kind of opinion like, oh, India is third country of this planet. India is poor. India is like this. But at the end, many passengers, many people travel for medical treatment to India and for really hard cases.
So this happens, one of the primary reasons is that the medical treatment in India and many parts of Southeast Asia is much more cheaper than as you would compare it to the US or
Europe
or any of these countries. Because in India, first of all, we have a very huge population. So I would say the hands-on practice for the doctors that are over here is pretty high. My parents are doctors, my sister is a doctor. I've seen them going through patients every day, regularly, and every day new patients. 365 days a year if you want to sit there. So it's, I would believe that because the population is so high, there are different kinds of complications in different diseases or in different operations or post-operative care, that the exposure is really high to the medical field over here. That would include nurse, doctors, everybody. I would say some of the senior doctors over here are very, very well educated. And
experienced.
Very well experienced, yes. I believe doctors everywhere are very well educated. It's all about, you know, day-to-day practice and being just doing many cases at the same time. So the post-operative care also, after you get a surgery done or if you're getting a treatment done, the cost of living that you would have in India would be much lesser. You can have your family members join in. And overall, the cost of living, if you stay here for a month or 2 months or 3 months, it would not damage you, it would not affect your medical bills or the overall money that you're spending so much. Dziękuję wam kochani! Buziaczki, buziaczki!
Dziękujemy wam serdecznie za oglądanie. Zapraszamy do polubienia mojego kanału, a także dajcie łapkę w górę. Następnym razem przygotujemy dla was kolejną porcję ciekawostek.
Dziękuję.
Dziękuję. Namaste.
Namaste.